Wow, I bet Warner Brothers sure wishes this movie didn't exist, but it does. I'm sure Warner Brothers wishes this wasn't how Wonder Woman came to be, but it is. This is also from Annapurna Pictures, Megan Ellison's production company that has now become a distributor. Annapurna Pictures hasn't had a ton of luck on the award circuit, despite the highbrow talent she's been able to attract with blank checks. So maybe she feels if she releases these movies herself, things will go better. I don't know. I saw the movies she released. I thought they had a lot of problems. I think you should never give anyone a blank check financially or creatively. Producers exist for a reason, to rein in talent and keep it on track, both financially and creatively. So let's see how this looks. I'm a big Luke Evans fan. I've always liked Luke Evans, but after Gaston, big fan. And I'm sure to some degree Disney is like, who are you playing, Luke Evans? And Luke Evans is like, I need to act. Although after watching screenings of Beauty and the Beast and seeing the laughs that he got with Josh Gad, he was like, maybe I should do more comedy. And let's see how he's faring in drama, where he felt his future truly was. All right, let's take a look.
Who's Charles Moulton?
That is my pseudonym.
Why don't you write Wonder Woman under your real name? Because most Americans have a low opinion of comic book writers.
I'm doing weird stuff, that's why.
Or is it something else?
It's something else.
A person is most happy when they are submissive to a loving authority.
I want to study her.
She'll break your heart.
Don't be jealous.
I'm your wife, not your jailer.
I think you long for an unconventional life.
Maybe I just want her because you do. You think it's possible to love two people at the same time?
Why not?
What is normal?
It can never happen.
The world won't let it.
The world can't stop us.
Is this what you really want?
Dr. Marston,
every issue of Wonder Woman is filled with violence, torture, and sadomasochism.
This abnormal behavior in your comic is reckless.
Those are real panels.
A woman must not be told how to use her freedom. She must find out for herself.
If you want to understand the mind of a woman, you can start with that.
You are brilliant, pure of heart, hilarious, ferocious.
You are
my life.
Wonder Woman has a secret identity. Why is that?
She has to hide her true self from man's world.
What would happen if Wonder Woman's secret identity was revealed?
Everything would be lost.
I wonder if you were the one with a secret identity.
Come on, Superman and Batman have secret identities too. Let's not be ridiculous here. I just find it so interesting that they're like, oh, he was at the cutting edge of understanding women. And you're like, well, I think the two women in the relationship with him seem to be getting the short end of the stick. And is their freedom really, that's the definition of freedom to them? That they can both be in a relationship with Luke Evans, right? Although it does make you think interestingly about his decision to have the Amazons, you know, live on an island, you know, although that's from mythology, but still the appeal of that, right? Because there's always been that question about Wonder Woman's sexuality that still, is a question to this day. But I think it's so weird to talk, you know, I guess maybe, this is such a tricky story to tell. Like, is that as much freedom as those women could get at that time? Or is that genuinely how what they felt was freedom? Like, if they really wanted to be free, why didn't they write Wonder Woman, right? And will the movie suggest that perhaps that all three of them wrote Wonder Woman? I don't know. It didn't seem that way to me. It seemed like those two women were like, let's have S&M games. And William Marston was like, you know, if I drew this in a comic book, I bet I could make a lot of money. Although, of course, I don't think that he ever totally did. I mean, it became property of DC. But those are real panels, and there's a lot of bondage in the early days of Wonder Woman. And, you know, although there's crazy panels in the early Batman stuff, too, with him and Robin, you know, like really weird stuff. One of the reasons that the Comics Code Authority had to be established. Very, very interesting. You know, people like to think that oh, you know, the olden days were pure. And it's like, no, there were just really strict rules. There was the comics authority, there was the production code in Hollywood. And if you look at things in entertainment before those rules were, you know, heavily enforced, it was just as crazy as it is today. You know, I really think that technology and style change, but don't be fooled. I think the people stay the same. And a lot of what people are thinking and how they interact with each other is remarkably similar. And I think shows like, for instance, The Nick, Steven Soderbergh's The Nick, which takes place in early 1900s New York, does a really good job of portraying that. But the only thing that's different is what people are wearing and what is available to them in terms of, you know, technology and, I guess, to some degree, society at that. But people themselves are the same. I don't know. This seems very sensationalized to me. It does not seem like a very interesting exploration of how Wonder Woman came to be. It's more like, oh, he was doing kinky stuff. You want to watch? That's what this trailer reads like. So what do you think? And were you aware of the history of Wonder Woman? And what do you think of this existing after what the film has accomplished? Characters evolve. I don't think it's going to affect Wonder Woman at all. Although, the more people know about her kinky background, the more people will use it as a joke. And that could be problematic. That could be problematic, actually, now that I think about it. So we'll see what happens. Write your thoughts down below. As always, thanks for watching with me. And you can check out some more videos right now.